The basic idea of fascism was government control over the private economy and government control over the lives of citizens. That's the meaning of fascism. That's what it is. That's what the Nazis were all about, the National Socialist Party. In my movie, well, we have some Dr. Ford enthusiasts here. Let me ask you guys this question. Well, okay, if you'll stop chanting, I'll address your point. Here's something interesting. Where is Dr. Ford? You know, this is really interesting. When Roy, hold on, don't shout at me. You'll have a chance to ask questions. When Roy Moore was attacked by all these women, he oppressed me, he did this, he did that. And suddenly, when he's defeated, they all melt into air. This is Karl Marx. All that is solid melts into air. Suddenly, the media, hold on, don't shout at me. You came voluntarily. Did I ask you to come? No, don't shout at me. I'm defending fascism. No, I'm exposing you as a fascist. Do you realize? I'll tell you how. You asked me a question. Hold on. Are you familiar with the black shirts in Italy or the brown shirts in Germany? Do you realize that they would go to campuses, goons, and would stand in the back of the room, and when somebody tried to make an intelligent presentation and answer questions, they would shout them down, yell at them, try to intimidate them, and count as success if they could get the event canceled and the speaker threatened. But see, the problem is, sometimes you get speakers like me who are not scared of people like you. We recognize your frauds. I recognize that ultimately you are afraid of ideas. You're not willing to engage with me. Yes, you're afraid of ideas. You're not afraid of fascists. You think I pose a threat to you? I'm an immigrant. I came to America with nothing. What threat do I pose to you?
Lincoln was elected to unite a country and stop slavery. Democrats smeared him, went to war against him, assassinated him. Now their target is Trump. They say he's a racist, a fascist. But who are the real racists and fascists? A nation dies, but its people are not free. It's now up to us to save America a second time.